defeated by the weather a month earlier, I am at last on my way to a Scottish island populated exclusively by birds. A small group of us have been given the chance to visit and land on the Bass Rock. But first, some photographic advice from our Scottish seabird guide, Maggie.
We're heading out to the Bass Rock. It's one of these most wonderful places. It's really important that you enjoy it. The only way to enjoy, you're going to somewhere that's going to overwhelm you. Can you imagine going on holiday and covering one eye with a hand, putting a patch on your eye, covering the other eye partially, jumping off the plane, and not until you return back to that aeroplane do you take the patch and the shade off your eye and you suddenly see this beautiful world. This is what people do when they put a camera in front of their eyes. They arrive somewhere, they get terribly excited, and they miss so much by not just taking a little bit of time to watch. It's so important that you do. We have people come here and maybe after 2 hours they haven't seen a chick, and the reason is they've clamped that camera to their eyes straight away. And it's just, if you sit and you watch the wildlife, you see what's happening, you'll see the behaviour, you'll see the bonding, the mating, the young chicks, the feeding. And it's very important that you just allow yourself that time to sit and watch.
Life jacket safely in place, we're on our way in this small fishing boat. The skipper stopped to throw some fish into the sea and attract the gannets, what they call chumming. Gannets are the largest seabird in the North Atlantic, with a wingspan of up to 2 meters. They can dive from a height of 30 meters at speeds of up to 100 kilometers an hour. The rock has a haughty, forbidding grandeur, and each having negotiated a tricky landing, we make our way up the cliff face and rest. This is Glastonbury with the Vuvuzela. There was an estimated occupied 80,000 nests on the rock at the height of the breeding season. listening devices and webcams record the sights and sounds for the rest of the world through the web. Taking Maggie's advice, we sit enthralled by the tenderness of the nurturing process on these large feet. That your mother's foot has never been better known. Gulls are predators on the fledgling gannets, but they also have their own young to care for. American cousins would probably call this a relationship interface. To us, it's just foul behavior. Little doubt about the empathy here. Is this envy or disapproval? Too soon, our boat has arrived for the return trip. As we make our way back, I muse on this exciting, enticing, enthralling, stimulating experience. I was an intruder, but met mostly with tolerance. There was an admirable egalitarianism about the colony. 25% of British children on the mainland we're now approaching are born into enduring poverty. Proportionately, in some areas, their chances of long-term survival are only marginally better than those of the fledgling gannets. My thoughts are interrupted by this little fellow. Now, whatever could he want?